Hey everyone, it is late at night and I am Norman. I typically tend to back into my most prized watches. That is, I purchase them not knowing a ton about them, but once I own them, I kind of begin to obsess about them, and I begin to dig into their history and other information about them. Currently, my most prized watch is my Pull Router. So, of course, I am now obsessed with Universal Genève and Gerald Genta. So I figured it would be fun to dig into as many of his designs as I could fit into one video, and that's what we're doing tonight. So one of the challenges that I had in digging up photographs is a lot of his designs are still being produced. And so it's tough to track down what his original designs looked like versus modern designs that carry on the same exact name and capture the spirit of his original design, especially when it comes to the pieces that Bulgari puts out. So if some of the images that I share tonight are actually not his original designs, please feel free to let me know in the comments below. Not surprisingly, the first design that we're going to look at tonight is the Pull Router, or as it was originally called, the Polar Router. These pieces were made available to the general public in 1955. My understanding was that a young Gerald Genta designed the Pull Router. However, Genta, at just 23 years old, was actually a contributing designer to the watch. The designs were realized in 1954 and made available publicly the next year. There are a ton of variations of the Pull Router, so if you love these amazing watches, you have a lot of different options to choose from, if you can track them down. The next design on my list is the Omega Constellation from 1959. I've actually had the pleasure of experiencing one of these watches, and it's absolutely amazing. I'm generally not a gold tone person, but seeing the constellation in the flesh, it is just a brilliant looking watch. And you can see touches of the design cues that went into the Pull Router in the constellation. The earlier designs of this watch had a pie pan style dial, but later on they were updated to a flat dial. However, all of the variations feature the Geneva Observatory etched into the case back. These are watches that you really have to see in person. They are just absolutely brilliant. And just like the Pull Router, photographs and videos just don't quite do them justice. The next design on my list is the Patek Philippe Golden Ellipse from 1968. Modern variations of this design are still being produced, so I had to track down what the original looked like. The case is not quite as tall as they are now, however the modern pieces still have the same batten markers and Bauhaus style stick hands. These watches are super unique and really dressy and just beautiful. They have small beveled bezels and they're a lugless design. These pieces are super elegant and dressy. Next up is Genta's most famous design and the watch that saved the luxury watch industry, the Audemars Piguet Royal Oak from 1972. AP, like other brands in the 70s, were under the throes of the quartz crisis, and they needed to do something revolutionary to save themselves. They decided to go with an all-steel luxury piece, and they decided that Genta was the designer who could pull it off. So in 1971, the night before Basel Fair, they contacted Gerald Genta and told him their idea. Now that call went out at 4 p.m. and by the next morning he had the Royal Oak all drawn up. And this design, according to Genta, was his masterpiece. The Royal Oak, along with two other of his designs, saved the luxury industry. It was the Royal Oak, the Ingenieur, and the Nautilus. And the next piece I want to discuss is the IWC Ingenieur, which was released in 1976. This design definitely shares some of the inspiration that went into the Royal Oak. The bezel has dots cut into it, which gives it sort of a rivet look, a lot like the Royal Oak, and it has an integrated bracelet. This design is somewhat more minimal and a bit cleaner than the Royal Oak. I really like its clean Thule aesthetic. The next design is the Patek Philippe Nautilus, which was released in 1976. The Nautilus has a very similar bracelet to the Ingenieur, and this design, along with the Royal Oak, are probably his most well-known designs. What's cool is the Nautilus gets its name from the submarine in 20,000 Leagues Under the Sea. Its bezel is actually pretty round, but there is an octagonal hint to it. It was designed to kind of resemble the portals that you would see in submarines. Even the sides of the case kind of resemble hinges that you would see on those portals. And having experienced an affordable but yet really nice Nautilus homage watch, I kind of get why this design is so loved. Now this next design is an interesting one. The Bulgari Bulgari from 1977. And the design is about as strange as the watch's name. Genta drew upon ancient Roman design cues when he was designing these pieces. They have an exaggeratedly cylindrical case, and Bulgari is etched around the bezel. There are also variants that have city names etched around the bezel. The Touch of Modern website had a boxed set of all of these watches. The set was sold, of course. The next design that I have on my list is the Cartier Pasha de Cartier from 1985. These watches were Cartier's answer to some of the steel sports designs that Genta himself had disrupted the industry with, and it follows closely on the heels of the release of the Santos. That piece was released in 1978. The Pasha de Cartier featured a very unique dial with a square-shaped railroad-style minutes track inside of the numeric indices. These pieces even have a rotating diving-style bezel on them, and the crown was protected by a screw-down cap. The water resistance on these watches was 100 meters, but with that special cap, I would expect more. The design was an attempt to merge sporty watches with the dressy elegance that Cartier was known for. And at the time, these pieces were considered pretty large at 38 millimeters. In the 1980s, Genta secured the rights to use Disney characters in his designs. So interestingly, in the late 1980s, he designed luxury Mickey Mouse watches. The particular watch that I found pictures of online looks absolutely amazing. It displays the minutes around the top of the dial from 8 all the way around to 4, and at the 6 o'clock it shows the hour in a window. Before retiring and spending the remainder of his life painting and doing other artistic ventures like that, Genta decided to try his hand at yet another watch company. So in 2000, he founded Genta Charles, and you can still purchase watches from this company. These are definitely luxury watches, coming in at over $16,000. These pieces have a super unique case shape, and in spite of their very dressy appearance, they're actually pretty sporty and they have 100 meters of water resistance. So there you have it, a list of some of Genta's designs. Now my understanding is he actually came up with thousands of watch designs. I think one site even said 100,000 designs. Madness. So this is just a fraction of what he's done. Thanks for watching.